Hello everyone, and welcome to an exciting video of... Oh, crap. Well, I already messed that up. Alright, that's a problem. Well, anyway, welcome to a video of League's Joust. Today, I am going to be playing Anubis versus this lovely Freya right here. Ranked Joust, of course. Not much to say here other than the fact that just did actually play a League's Joust match before this, and I was successful. I was 6-0, but that person lagged out, was walking in the walls. It was really strange. Doesn't look like we're gonna get invaded here. Most Freyas typically don't, considering the fact that they don't have much to invade with. So what I meant to do when I said I messed up was put 2 points into my grasping hands here. So that's a small issue, but it shouldn't be a problem when we get into lane here, because I should get my levels. And I would have put the point into mummify anyway, so we should be all good there. Freya has cooldown boots as her first item. It's okay. I wouldn't say it's solid, but personally, I'd rather pen boots on Freya and just get cooldown from other items. But what I'm going to be going for this game, I am also going to be, not cooldown boots, but I will be getting pen boots, specifically for the fact that I will be getting my cooldowns from other items. From other items such as Breastplate of Valor. It's a very good one. Actually, no. Never mind, scrap that, because she is... Jeez. I am tripping over my words. But, she has magical damage. I am magical damage. So, I'm probably gonna spring for Stone of Gaia. It's one of the best things you can get against magical gods. Which makes me really sad. Alright, looks like she's gonna be going into Fatalis here. Get that attack speed up. Which is very good on Freya. But... What's interesting is, we both have some passive rounding around our lifesteal. Now, mine, I steal protections, her, she just gets passive lifesteal, which is pretty good. But whenever I play Freya, she does not have the amount of lifesteal compared to Anubis. In my personal opinion, I feel as if Anubis has the best lifesteal in the game. Because last game I was hitting ticks of like 50, 60, 60 some lifesteal. It was obnoxious, and I could heal more than half of my health just from one wave. Because notice I said like 50 and 60s? That's per tick. And grasping hands is 0.5 seconds for every 2 seconds. Oh, alright. I was just trying to read Freya. I didn't want any. So she's gonna ult here. And miss every single part of it. I only took damage from the minions there. So that was a bit bad. I do have enough. This is getting obnoxious. I do, however, have enough to... now that we know the ult's burned, I can... Oh my god, if I hit that, I would have ulted her and probably would have wound up in a kill. So, is she gonna back? She is. I want to damage the wave a bit more. Let's do that. Let's recall. So, notice I'm only getting one lifesteal because that's with a 4% magical lifesteal. This is gonna give me the 15 magical lifesteal, and it's also gonna give me the passive of 10% more, so we're getting 25% lifesteal just from Pythagorean's piece. And Nubis is passive, I'll let you take a look at it. So, And I also get 30% reduction on all crowd control durations, which is good because Anubis doesn't have many, he doesn't have any abilities dedicated to an escape. Like, Mummify is a stun. I guess Grasping Hands and the Mummify could be. but you'd have to combo it and hit both of those. Three, not hard to hit at all. Two, sure. I mean, after all, I do miss. I do mostly miss at the longest of ranges, but I have hit a few snipes with it. I didn't understand. Unless she has boots. Oh, no, she has... she does have boots and fatalis. Or getting towards... What did she buy when she recalled? Did she buy anything? So you can see how my lifesteal is combating this Freya's basic attacks. And that's really vital, because if you don't have quite the healing or lifesteal that Anubis does... I know I'm referencing if you don't have Anubis's standards, but I think it applies because next to maybe Hell or like a large heal just in a burst or a per tick, maybe Aphrodite could, but you need something that can keep up with her. Like, you can see her attack speed is getting higher now that she's gonna start a ring, either Demonic Grip or Telkin's Ring, now that she also has Fatalis, which is going to get rid of that movement penalty for using her basics. Alright. Yeah, but she's not very good at hitting her ult, which doesn't mean too much, because you're mostly going to be on the ground doing your basics. But now that we know that ult's burned, that's Freya's one true escape. Damn. Last game I was hitting them easy. That's not so much. But I do have enough for pen boots when I do go back. And after that, I guess I'll start some sort of magical protection. I'll look at the shop. Take a final gander before we make a purchase. Let's get up close and personal right here. Damn. That just ruined that. Alright, I guess I'll recall. Now, that thing about Frey, now that she's getting all of her items, she could push a wave pretty well. Not as well as I could, because it's gonna get to the point for me that I can use one ability and the wave will be gone. And there it goes. Alright. So that's gonna give my min- actually, no, I should push the... I have no minions. Alright. I want to stay. Damn it. Tell you what, I am going to plop this down. I'm going to run away into the jungle and recall. That way I still get some of the XP for the minions. Now my ult does... if I hit all of it, which helps with the mummify, I get lots and lots of planes and trains. By planes... no. Silly reference there, but... Ooh, Voidstone might be good. Get a bit of pen protection. Well, it's not necessarily pen, it just reduces protections. I kinda like that. Gaia is 70 protections, but I kinda like this more, so we're just gonna sit and wait. I don't use Voidstone too frequently, but I think I may start. And, I have to be relatively up close and personal for, what does it say? I'm fine to check it right now. 55 units. And for example, my, let's find something. Now that's a radius. Doesn't really tell me. I don't know how long of a range that is. Yeah, she's clearing camps. That's a good move by her. But like, if the radius on this is 20, so like, a bit over two times the diameter of that, so like, that's pretty close, that's awfully big. May not be exact, but... Oh, wait, no, radius is halfway. I'm thinking of diameter. Alright, so yeah, it'd be about the size of the circle. A little bigger. Damn! I am off my game today. At least I can keep up with the wave. What is she doing? Oh, sweet prince. Princess more. Damn. Well, she clearly took that. She came from there, so let's see if the left is up. But for those of you who do not know what Demonic Grip does, I was talking about it earlier. For every basic attack that you hit, it reduces protection. I can actually bring it up for you since I'm playing the same type of god here. Magical, that is. Yeah. So you're going to see that this is reducing magical protection and additional 5 points for 3 seconds. And it stacks 3, so 21% reduction, as well as 15 more protections. So it's very good, again, on these basic attack mages such as Aokwong, Freya, and Kronos. Soul 2, she's a new one. But there was one game that I did get a little upset with a ally who picked Kukul Khan when I was Anubis, and I built attack speed. Oh, so I'm cooled out. Got lucky there. But I did build basic attack Anubis. Surprisingly, I got it full basic attack, mind you, so like little to no anything else, such as like Rod to Hootie or anything like that. But as soon as I saw that it could work and it could be a thing, I did start changing it around, and I started using it, and it was funny how well it was working against this team. Given they might have been bad, I was aware that we could have won the game much earlier had I not done what I did and built basic attack out of pure frustration of the Smite community. But I did learn a few things in that game. Okay, we're gonna have to teach the lady some manners here. For those of you who don't know, Freya actually translates to the lady, or something relatively close to that. Jeez. I want... If she goes for Divine Ruin, that would be a good idea, but Polynomicon would also be a good idea. Divine Ruin would halt my healing a bit. And she needs that, I can tell. Like, one of the best things to do with an Anubis, and this is one of the best tips I can offer, try and engage in combat, like, next to a minion wave, if you can. So, like, this applies for any god, really. Other ally minions can help you, as well as you could, so, like, I'm just gonna... So that's sort of like the escape, but... Oh, okay. Sort of... Cheaper out there. This isn't looking good. She got me. Yeah, I wasn't paying attention there. I was counting on the minion wave coming a bit faster. But we did get a large increase in magical power there. I did give her a kill. Bit more cooldown. Let's look under the cooldown category. It should be up any second though. Spirit Bird? No, she doesn't have a hard CC. Guess we're gonna wind up going for Kronos Pendant here. Safe to sell this now. I don't know what I get. I guess mana. With a Book of Toth. I have friends that say it's sometimes a bit late to start building stacks, but I never feel that way. Considering the fact that you can get stacks from getting kills, and if late game you can get a lot of kills, then building stacks isn't such a bad idea. And it's, yeah, so like, I ticked her for a bit there. Yeah, she did get Polynomicon. It's not a bad choice. Yeah, like I said, bad at hitting at long range. But the reason why I placed down my 3 first is it's a slow. And it sort of makes it easier to hit. I don't know. Get rid of the problem there. I bet you I could have ulted her before I died. I didn't think it was really worth it, so I tried to hold on to it, I should say. Let me get my health back. Anubis is one of my favorite gods for League's Joust, if I didn't say that already. Like, the reason why I'm having trouble saying things that I didn't say before. Like, I may have said half of these. Uh oh. This isn't good. Yeah, no. That was a bit silly. She got me there. Maybe I should have gone to cooldown. Oh well. Yeah. But yeah, I stuck around too much. But as I was saying, I did try to record my previous match, but I did run into technical difficulties. It's fine now. It's all resolved. I just had to scrap all the footage, which I wasn't too proud of. But as I said earlier in the video, that person was running into walls, lagged out the game. Really wasn't a fair match. This I feel a bit differently about. This is a fair match. She's gonna try and banish me. I can tell. Yeah. Alright. Alright, try and upgrade that there. Uh-oh, this isn't good. Why are they following me? Oh, damn. Come on. Alright. Should get a bunch of health. Good. Smart of her to ult me. Or, not ult me rather, but ult out. Oh, damn. I have clipped her every single time. Yeah, nothing new. She did have beads though. That's a bit interesting. Yeah, so I'm hitting like 70 lifesteal. Per tick. Oh, she's gone. Yeah, see, this is an interesting match because we're two gods that if you get your opponent trapped, they're gone. So, it's just a matter of who can get who trapped. It's a bit interesting, actually. I kind of like it. But unfortunately, this is the game. I know it doesn't look like it. The Titan's at full health. But, yeah, I'm terribly sorry. But that's gonna be game here. That's a pretty decent match, I'll admit. Can I throw off a... Hey, little lantern. Yeah, but I enjoyed that match. It's pretty fun. Alright. Well, thank you guys for watching so much. It's a bit of a shame that I had to go through a second video of getting it out to you guys. But I'm proud to do it. And I have no problems with it. And after all, I do really love Smite. If you don't know what it's about, I recommend that you try it out. It's a free game on PC and Xbox. If you like playing on Xbox, that's where I play. So yeah, here are the builds that we both use. Oh yeah, she did go for Pestilence. That was smart, but you really can't build protections too late. Otherwise, it's gonna... Like, you can build them late, don't get me wrong, it's just more effective early game than it is late game. Because by then people will be tearing through protections easily, and like Anubis steals protections as passively. So yeah, here's the little charts here. Surprisingly did a lot more minion damage, like, what is that, 20-some, no, that's not 20-some thousand, that's about, I don't know. Maybe 15,000, yeah, around 15,000 more. Somewhere around there. But the time she got me, she was pounding me. I didn't have protection. No, I did. Like, I wouldn't normally recommend Soul Gem or something. I forget what it's called. But, I wouldn't normally use it for protections. It's a great pen item, especially if you're on a Guardian, because those are more up close and personal. Anubis is sort of in between there. He does have range, but his one Plague of Locusts, and you have more of a chance hitting his stun mummify up close. And that's how I feel about that. But that's all I have to say about this match. Good game. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!